it's Jeanette J Beauty and welcome to my channel. First off, I want to acknowledge all the new people here. Thank you so much to everyone that has just subscribed to me. I've noticed I receive many new subscribers and it means so much to me to know I have so many people that are here and support me. I tell many of you all the time, without you, I would not be where I am today, and just to be able to not only support myself, but also my four children. And I am forever grateful and appreciative for everyone that is here today. So with that being said, I want to go over a little bit about me and my channel really quickly. My name is Jeanette, obviously, and I titled my channel Jeanette J Beauty because I love all things beauty, and not just in a physical sense, but mentally, emotionally, physically, spiritually, and of course, I'm going to talk about some financial aspects later in the year because it's very important. I am in my early 30s. Looking and reflecting back in my 20s, there's so much that I wish I was prepared for and knew, so that's why I want to reflect that and show you here in my channel and just make many videos. I'm very creative, very fun, very loving, optimistic, very positive. I know many of you subscribe to me for my hair and fitness. I think between those two, that's what many of you are here for. Comment down below why you are subscribed to me. I really want to know. I know that many of us, we look for healthy hair tips and what's gonna help us with healthy hair. For me, I want to grow my hair very long, maybe about tailbone length. I was there about 7 years ago, and then I started coloring, cutting, and just doing a whole bunch to my hair. And then I eventually did the big chop, and I've cut my hair a few times since I've done the big chop. Now I'm just letting my hair grow, flourish, and be healthy. And I just want to share with you what has worked really well for my hair and what could be universal, because I know all of us, we have different hair types, porosities, densities, curl patterns. All of it is beautiful, it's gorgeous, and I just want to help you take care of your hair and what is going to work best for you. I have come up with 5 tips that I can think of that are just paramount and that is going to work for everyone. So let's just get this video started. I know this intro was long enough, but I just want to introduce myself to anyone that is new. And I also have my notes right here because I have been planning to make a video like this for quite some time, and now I have the opportunity to do that. So my first tip is to have low maintenance or protective styles, just like I have today. I love twisting my hair, and sometimes I braid my hair, but it could take a lot of time. So my go-to style is twist for a style or a twist out. One, I could just style my hair and not have to think about it, and my hair loves it, it thrives. And many of you have also commented that this works really good for you, that you've just twisted your hair or wear your hair in low maintenance slash protective styles for most of 2020 and it grew because you're not manipulating your hair. Your hands are just out of your head. You're not doing so much to it where you could cause friction, breaking your hair, snapping it, and just doing the most to your hair. I just know from experience this works so well. And I style my hair once. I won't style it again to maybe a week to 2 weeks at the max later. So no matter your curl type, porosity, texture, it doesn't matter. You can still twist your hair if you want your hair to grow long, to be healthy. You can keep it out of your face. You can still style your hair and just let your hair be. And also your wash days before you style your hair and twist are also important, because for me, I'll leave my hair like this for a week up to two, and I want to make sure that my scalp health is on point. That's why a lot of times I will do a scalp exfoliator, just to make sure that I'm getting rid of all that buildup. You want to have a nice clean environment on your scalp because your hair is growing from your scalp. You want your hair to grow nice and healthy. And also protective styles, those are really good where your ends are covered. It really does help with the overall integrity of your hair. Trust me, and also look at some of the comments in the video. Many of you tell me your hair has just been flourishing with these types of styles, and you can go longer if you want. Also, when I do style my hair, I do trim the ends, and that is very important because it can help prevent the ends from splitting up if you have split ends, but I'm gonna go into that shortly. And I also wanted to add that protective styles, the low maintenance styles, aren't just twists or variations of twists, but you also have cornrows, braids, and you can add hair in. I don't really add hair in. I have a couple times, but that's it. I like to style my natural hair and just have my hair be, but there's so many styles that you can wear that you just protect your hair, even a bun. And it brings me to my next tip, to trim your hair as needed. Now, I get asked all the time, how often do I trim my hair? And I'll say now, since I've had a good routine, it's been about every 3 or 4 months. But that works good for me. I know some naturals, it's once a year, some it's twice a year. You just have to find what works for you. I will say, if you notice that your hair, like you have a straggly end, or the ends aren't really curling, or you notice that it's frayed, it's damaged, it's just not curling as properly and you've done treatments and nothing is working, I would recommend to clip that ends off. If I do see that my hair is not curling at the ends, or it's damaged, it's fried, it's frizzy, it's just split, for whatever reason, if it got snagged on a button on one of my tops, say I did something and my hair got damaged, it didn't like it, or it's thin in that area, whatever, I will trim it, because I'm not going to wait the next month too, or the next time I'm gonna trim my hair, then to cut it. Because what can happen, and most likely will happen, is that split end or the damage is going to travel up, and you don't want that to happen at all. I've had that happen, I think, like a couple times, where I was thinking, okay, I'm on a set schedule and it's not that bad, I can wait. No, just trim it, cut it off right then and there, stop the damage in its tracks. And of course, I have several videos on how I trim my hair. And I think if you twist your hair, like doing something like this, and you notice that the ends of your hair aren't curling, or it just has a wonky shape to it, then you know that's where you want to cut. So I think trimming your hair while you have twist may be the best option if you don't want to go to a stylist right now. Also, I wanted to add, if you put heat on your hair, or your hair just got damaged and you noticed that there's a lot of damage at the end, I would highly recommend to maybe do like a treatment or two, but after you've tried for about a month and it's not working, there's still some ends there, just cut it off. Cut it off, cut your losses, and learn your lesson. Third tip, which has to be to deep condition your hair weekly. Deep condition, deep condition, deep condition. I love deep conditioning, and it's different from a conditioner because it's more intense, and I love it. I know for some of you, you do a shampoo and a deep condition, and that's it. For me, I find that doing 4 steps on wash day works really good, and I'm able to set my week off with styling my hair very well. So I'll do a pre-shampoo. It goes before shampoo, hence the name, shampoo, conditioner, and deep conditioner. I love it. It works so good. But as it pertains to deep conditioning, add a plastic cap on it. And if you want to take it a step further, you can sit under a hooded dryer, of course, with a plastic cap on. So there is such a thing as direct heat. That's when you're diffusing your hair, or you're flat iron, blow drying. And then you have indirect heat when you use with treatment. So if you put a plastic cap on and then you put a hooded dryer, or even a soft hood dryer on, it's gonna work the same. You're heating the deep conditioner up, and it's just getting those follicles stimulated. But deep conditioning is a must, especially if you have natural hair. Natural hair is known to be a little bit on the drier side. Deep conditioning is going to help with the elasticity of your hair, and that's that bounce back. You want your curls to have that elasticity. If you pull your hair down, like say for instance me, I'm pulling my hair down, it popped back. You want it to do that. Now say I pulled my hair and it stayed right here and didn't move, that is a sign of damage. So the hair strands, it could be stripped, but it's just not a good sign. So anytime we get shrinkage, and I know many of us, we hate shrinkage, but just take it as a sign of healthy hair. And like I was saying, you may want to do a few treatments if you don't want to just go cold turkey and cut the damage off. There are a few treatments I would recommend. One is the We Dad Curl Recovery, or Meltdown Curl Recovery Hair Mask. That is really, really, really good. Also, the Afrogy, they have their 2-step protein treatment. That's really good. And I love the Olaplex. I think that that whole line, the number 3, 4, and 5, those are really good. Also, the Monos Hair is a scalp and curl clarifier. I would also recommend that because they have ingredients that work so good for the hair and just to get that curl bounce back. I know when I apply that to my hair, my curls are popping, like popping. So good. Those are the different products that I can think of right now on the top of my head that would be good just to help address and try to remedy a little bit of that damage. Now, it just depends on how major or minor the damage is, but if it's a lot, it's up to you at your discretion. All right, on to tip number 4 is to have a moisture mix. Now, I think that this is very, very, very important, and that we are in the colder months. A moisture mix could be as simple as mixing water and having castor oil, jojoba oil. It could be 2 products or it could be a lot more. I have a couple videos and I will link them in the iCards and also description box where I made my own moisture mix. I love doing DIYs and I will make a lot more in the upcoming months. But making your own products, you could really curate it to what you need, what your hair needs, what your scalp needs, and it works so good for you. But I would highly recommend to see what types of products your hair likes. If you have thicker hair, thinner hair, or say you don't like protein, you know, just figure out what your hair reacts well to and you can make your own products. Now, a moisture mix, like I said, it can be very simple, it can be more intricate. I like ones where I'm mixing at least 4 to 5 products. I find that, I don't know, I just like to be my own chemist. Your hair is dry and you notice that your hair and scalp especially is dry, spray some of your moisture mix on. Also, rosemary is really good for a dry, flaky scalp. Rosemary essential oil, spray some of that on. I have talked to many naturals individually and they started incorporating moisture mix in their flaky scalp, itchy scalp, irritated scalp was no longer the case. I'm not a licensed professional, but I like to go the natural route in every area of my life. I don't go to the doctors for any ailments unless it's like major. But aside from that, I take the holistic approach. I want to make sure that my hair stays nice and healthy, very moisturized, because that's what's going to help it grow nice. I don't want my hair to be long and stringy, straggly, or frayed and just damaged. That is no good. There's no point of having long damaged hair. So I did apply my moisture mix a few days ago and I just want to make sure that my hair still has that nice sheen to it. I don't want to weigh it down. So you have to find out what works best for you, like castor oil, shea oil, they're going to be a little bit heavier, but then you have jojoba oil is very light, and then you have avocado, grapeseed oil somewhere in the middle. So just find your consistency, what you like. Water is a moisturizer alone. It's very lightweight, but adding oils and other products are going to help, especially vitamin E oil. That's really good and serves as a humectant. So just, you know, play around and you will find a good mix and put it in your hair every other day, every other few days. What works good for you? The goal is to prevent your hair from drying out. When your hair is dry, it can break easily, get damaged very easily and quickly. So just, you know, we want to avoid all of that. So make sure your hair stays moisturized at all costs. And for my last tip, tip number 5, is to choose appropriate products / listen to your hair. I think those two, they go hand in hand, but it speaks volumes. For me, there's a lot of products that I can use and there's products that I can't use or just don't work well for me. I will say, if you know that you're allergic to an ingredient or it just does not work for your hair, maybe it makes it stiff, dry, brittle, do not use it. Pay close attention to certain products. If they have it in one of the and one of the highly popularized ingredients, coconut oil. Now, I love coconut oil and cooking with coconut oil as well. It's so good. Coconut milk, coconut water, it's good for me. And also my hair. Now, I know there's so many naturals that cannot use coconut oil, whether they would have an adverse reaction, they'll break out in hives on the scalp, on the body, or their hair will become dry, stiff, and brittle. Do not use coconut oil. If there's a new product, read the ingredients, because maybe 7 times out of 10, it may have coconut oil in it. Coconut oil is seen as one of those magic ingredients to work for everyone, and that's not the case. There are a lot of naturals that cannot use protein, so pay close attention if there's any protein ingredients, because there are certain ingredients that contain protein in it, not just one, and do not use that product. Now, I know for me, certain products that do have protein don't work in my hair at all. And then there's other products that have protein that work amazing in my hair. So I have to see what is going to work good and what is not going to work good by looking at the ingredient list. And another example where I have to give is, say you see another naturalista, her hair looks really good. You asked her, what is she using her hair? And she told you, and looking at the texture, the consistency of the product, you're like, I don't know if this is going to work in my hair. It seems very liquidy. I know that thicker products work really good in my hair. Chances are it may not work so good for you, and it could dry your hair out. I remember when I was first starting my natural hair journey, I had the big chop and I saw a lot of curlies, but their hair was thinner than mine. They would use mousse a lot, and I was like, should I use mousse? I don't know. There wasn't a lot to choose from in 2014 for natural hair, so I would use mousse. And I was like, oh my gosh, my hair is dry. It feels gross. Even when I was in high school with the whole scrunching up, I remember that was big. Combing through your hair with one of those paddle brushes and then scrunch, 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 scrunch. And I'm like, what is this? Like, this is not doing my hair any justice. But I see, you know, these naturals over there is working for their curls. But I had to see and analyze, like, their hair isn't as thick as mine. Maybe that's why it's not working for me. I have to choose products and techniques that are gonna work for me. You may need thicker products like creams or butters even. So if that's the case, pay attention to those consistencies when it comes to your stylers or even moisturizing products like in between. I don't typically use moisturizing butters or moisturizing sprays other than my moisture mix. My WLOS method, and it stands for my water, leave-in conditioner, oil, and my styler in that order. That's what I do. That's sufficient for me. I may apply some oil or some water midweek, say day 4 or 5, but that's it. So I know other naturals, they will moisturize their hair midweek with a moisture butter. That works good for them. And that's when I say choose products and routines that work good for you. And also listen to your hair. If you apply some products to your hair and your hair just feels gross after, whether it's like frizzy, dry, brittle, there's texture, like your hair feels like a Brillo pad, don't use it again. If you can return it and just say it didn't work for your hair. I've done that before. There are certain stores that will allow that, and that's why I like shopping at certain stores, because say you use it once or twice and it didn't work for you, you can bring it back. And another example I have is, say for instance you have wavy natural hair and you're using heavy butters like shea butter and a lot of castor oil on your hair, it could weigh it down. Now if you're using castor oil and just a little bit on your scalp and rubbing it in, that's one thing. But if you're using heavy products that have a lot of those butters that are intended for like really coarse, kinky, coily type of hair texture, you know, you just gotta see what is going to be good. If you have really thick hair, like my oldest son, he has really thick, coarse, beautiful, beautiful hair. So it's still, I have to make sure that I am giving him an adequate amount of moisturizing agents and also to help seal that moisture in, because his hair can get dry very, very quickly. So I need to make sure that I am on top of that. So I'm not gonna choose anything that's lightweight or for wavy, curly hair. No, we're past that. Choose products that have shea butter, maybe some castor oil, mango butter, or just really thick conditioning products. And even some of my products he can't use. And my third son too, his hair is thicker than mine. So a lot of the products that work good on my hair he can use, but when it comes to my daughter, she has very fine curly hair. And she could use products that work good for my hair and my third son, but for me and my other sons, we can't use it. Now my second son, his hair is fine and it's curly, like a little wavy curly, and that's the beauty of having natural hair. So it's just about seeing the ingredients and what type of hair is it for. Now I know there's so many types, but if you have like really coarse, kinky hair and you're using something lightweight, chances are it's not gonna work. And on the flip side, if you have thinner, fine hair and you're using butters and heavy oil, chances are it's gonna weigh your hair down. It's just gonna be counterproductive. So pay attention to your products, the ingredients, and what type of hair it's for. Now, when I say type, I'm not just going with curl type. I'm talking about porosities, densities, curl pattern, if it's wavy, curly, coily, kinky, or even the zigzag curl pattern. Pay attention to all of that and just listening to how your hair feels with that product in it. Does it feel good? Does it feel nourished? Does it feel gross, icky, slimy? There's even times where products just made my hair feel like mushy, and that's not good. That could be a sign of moisture overload, and that's something you want to avoid. Just like protein overload, you want to avoid that as well. But with this video, I want it to be very informative because I know what it feels like to just start my natural hair journey or just not really know where to turn. I mean, back in 2014, there was some information, some products, but not like there is today. And I'm so happy that just in society, a lot of people are recognizing the beauty of natural hair, and just there's so many naturals embracing their natural hair and just feeling empowered. I love this energy. I just wanted to put this video out there. And if you have any other video ideas, comment them down below. And I'm so happy I got through this video with ease, with these notes. And I really have to thank these courses that I have been watching on Skillshare when it comes to productivity and just expressing my creative self. I am a creator, and many of you know that I love creating content. I love it. So I have been watching these different types of videos on Skillshare. And the last video I was watching, the instructor was talking about productivity, also how it's important to research information to present. And let me rewind and talk about Skillshare. You may not know what Skillshare is, but let me tell you, Skillshare is an online learning community for creatives where millions come together to take the next step in their creative journey. And also, Skillshare offers thousands of inspiring classes for creatives and curious people on topics like illustration, design, photography, video, freelancing, and more. Like I was saying, productivity. And right now, I have to be very productive, especially everything going on, being a single mom, and just making sure my mental state is where it needs to be, because there's so much going on with virtual school and you know, I'm an entrepreneur, a self-employed businesswoman, so there's a lot of positions that I need to fill, so being productive definitely is important for me. And if you're wondering if Skillshare is good for you, I would say yes, because they have something on there literally for everyone. They have not only it bulleted, but also you could see the time. They have a good range of time. Like some videos that I've watched are maybe like 25 minutes and they could go to like an hour. And then there's also follow-ups that I think is important. Skillshare is for creatives and curious people, lifelong learners, real working creatives, beginners, pros, dabblers, and masters. And Skillshare is the sponsor for today's video, and they are a great company. And I'm not saying that because I'm sponsored, but I have looked into a lot of their videos and I have been able to retain a lot of their information, just like presenting this video to you. I was able to do so after watching that course, and I think I can compile my thoughts a lot better just seeing different pointers and advice that the instructors have to give, and a lot of takeaways. And you can also explore new skills, deepen existing passions, and get lost in creativity. There's so many courses that I think will appeal to you, like illustration, graphic design, photography, animation, fine arts, film and video, marketing, productivity, freelance and entrepreneurship, and craft. Skillshare is especially curated for learners, so there's no ads, and I like that I can get straight to the point with detail. A lot of times I need that detail. They're always launching new classes, so you could definitely get your money's worth. And with an annual subscription, it's less than $10 a month. And I say it's money well spent, especially if you're like me and you love bettering yourself and just continuing to learn. Like, there is no price on bettering yourself. That's valuable. And I wanted to share with you, the first 1,000 of my subscribers to click the link in the description will get a free trial of the premium membership so you can explore your creativity. You will not regret it. Of the course that I was watching called The Designer's Guide to Writing and Research by Stephen Heller. I will be sharing more tips. Let me know down below in the comment section if you would like to see it. I really hope that you enjoy the video. You have a great day, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye.